Hello friends, now we are continuing with last point of unit number 6. So the next point is the Amazon Web Services for IoT. There are the different services which are provided by the IoT for the Amazon. The first one is Amazon Web Services. That is nothing but the subsidiary of Amazon.com, which offers some several cloud-based on the demand platform which can be used for the IoT-based application development. The first one is service that is provided by the Amazon is Amazon EC2, that is Elastic Compute Cloud, which is the service which are widely used and that will provide some scalable computing capacity to its user. And also clients may scale up or the scale down the computing resources which is based on the changing the requirement. Suppose when the requirements are the higher, then it will be a scale up, and the requirements are the lower, it will be scaled down. According to the requirement that is given by the user, it will lag. So different kind of applications can be developed and deployed on the EC2, which is faster than the cloud services. So basically EC2 is faster than the cloud services which are provided, because suppose that clients needs to be invest on the hardware according to the various types of needs. So it will be the costly. So EC2 supports faster than that the hardware and the also by the cloud services. EC2 allows the clients to launch the many servers, and it will need and configure its security and networking. So likely EC2 offers and the manages resources like processor, the second one is your memory and the storage. And the important features of Amazon EC2 are computing machines can be created as required by, and it will be called as instances. So basically it will define and it will part in the different sections that will be basically on the requirements of the user. For the next one is the possible configuration of EC2 is determined by its CPU, memory, storage, networking capability. These configuration are called the instance type. I already told what are the instances, and the second one is the instance type. So EC2 allows the secure login to the machine by generating the key pair at the time of instance when they are creation. Means they are creating the public key which is sorted by the Amazon Web Services, and the clients that will maintain the private key. Means they are giving the private key to the client at the time of the installation. In the SPP paper, they may be asked the question is like that, explain the different cloud-based services which are offered by the Amazon for IoT. Otherwise, they will ask the sub-question also, explain the Amazon EC2 services which are provided by the Amazon for the IoT application development. Now, the second one is nothing but the Amazon Autoscaling. Amazon Autoscaling, which will allow very flexible upgrade and downgrade options to the clients of the EC2. So the clients of the EC2 using auto-scaling feature can dynamically scale up with the capacity of EC2 instance up or instance down. Means they are using the auto-scaling feature for the upgrading or the downgrade. The scaling criteria is also determined by the clients of EC2. Auto-scaling that will ensure that the applications running on the EC2 that will be the instances will remain available, so it users in any conditions. Auto scaling option is proved quite useful for IoT application where on specific time bulk of data is generated and need to be processed. So auto scaling is important for the flexible upgrade and the downgrade option of the client of the EC2. The next one is the Amazon S3, that is simple storage service. Second most popular service of the Amazon Web Services after that the EC2 is the S3. S3 is nothing but the Amazon simple storage service. This one is the faster and also efficient cloud-based storage service. This is the entire infrastructure for storage which is offered by the user for the fast storage and the retrieval of the large amount of data. In this simple storage service, data can be audio and the video too. So it will support the streaming of the data directly in the browser, media player, or it can be downloaded. So Amazon S3 is affordable. The second one feature is it is fast, it is scalable, it is quite easy that can be used. S3 can be quite useful for the first storage of the IoT application data. This can be generated from the sensor. So sensors are distributed over the geographical region. We are collecting that data in the centralized location. For that purpose, data generated can be managed by the next provider. So it is useful for the S3 that will support some cloud-based storage service. The next one is the Amazon Relational Database Solution. So Amazon offers the some convenient and efficient relational database solution that is called the RDS, Amazon Relational Database Solution. So it has a many features that will be a setup, scale and interface with the other application. Relational database solution that will be available on the cloud, so it is accessible from the anywhere from the multiple application. So data sharing among the distributed IoT application can be easily, and also it can be achieved by using the relational database solution. The most important feature is the Amazon RDS is cost effective solution for the database because of high performance. Second one is the fast retrieval, easy access. Then next one is the high security, and the few other features of the RDS can be available. RDS does not restrict the user from its specific kind of database. Can be they are compatible with the MySQL, MariaDB, Oracle. Then next one, Microsoft SQL servers. The last one service which are offered by the web services for the IoT is Amazon DynoDB. Amazon offers the NoSQL alternative and the traditional relational database solution for the DynoDB. So it is fully managed, scalable, and the performance of the data solution is the high, and it is quietly used for the IoT application for the data solution in the we have to transfer the data in the bulk format. So it is useful in that. So these are the services which are provided by the Amazon Web Services for the IoT based application development. Next one point to be discussed, that Skynet IoT messaging platform. Skynet, which is the one of the popular messaging platform for IoT application, is Skynet messaging platform. It is an instant messaging platform which supports the multiple APIs. So Skynet supports the APIs that like to be HTTP, REST and the WebSocket. So these platforms enables the devices to send the quick messaging reliably. So Skynet messaging platform manages the entire messaging between the nodes or the between the devices when we are transferring the data from one platform to the another platform. And the nodes can be available for the messaging of the services from the Skynet. So Skynet messaging platform manages the entire messaging from the nodes or the from the peers to peers. So devices are assigned for the unique ID. They are giving the unique ID. For example, like in the RFID device, they are providing some unique number. Like that in this Skynet messaging platform, they are giving the unique ID that we call the UID upon for the registration of the Skynet messaging platform. And these devices or the nodes can be also provided with the secret access on the token. So Skynet messaging platform basically supports the multiple APIs for the, and it is basically a messaging platform. They maybe ask the question like this: explain the Skynet IoT messaging platform for the 2 months, or it may be asked for the 4 months. You have to see the marking scheme and you have to give the answer like upon that. Next one is the Python Web Application Framework. That is nothing but the Django. It is a popular framework that is used for the developing the applications. It is basically supportable for the Python. Django is an open source framework for the developing Python web application and especially IoT application development. Okay, it will support for, it will provide some unified API to a database backend, and it will also support for the some websites for the effective based solutions. It will also support for the model template view. Okay, model template view is basically architecture that will be provide some separation of the data model from the business rules and the user interface. Thus, The web application that is built upon the Django can work with the different database without requiring the any code changes. The main important feature of the Django that consists of the object relational mapper, that is a web templating system. Basically, Django architecture contains the model template view, like that we have studied the model view controller, that is the traditional popular architecture that will support for the web application development. Like that, Django supports the MTV, that is model template view. Model, that is nothing but the interaction of the application with the database, which is handled through the model, and that model which will regulate the flow of the data. That the data can be generated, or that data can be generated and it will store for the relational or the non-relational database. It will be, for example, it will be form of the XML files or the etc. So model defines some rules that is related to the data storage and the retrieval of the data. Next one is the template. Django provides some special template language. That is, this language can be used to create some forms, some classes that using a predefined template. These templates can be create the form. For example, you can use the languages like XML, AML, CSS, JavaScript, or otherwise HTML for the creating of those pages. And the views ties with the model and template. It is the logic written in views which will determine some type of data which is required by that application. Means view where you write the code that actually generates the web pages. Means in model you are in model what you have done, you are defining the some rules for the data storage and for the retrieval of the data. In template you are providing some languages for the creating of the web pages, and in the view you are actually returning the logic that will be defined, that will generate some web pages. View determines what the data to be displayed, retrieves the data from the database and passes the data to that template. Okay, got it? What is the model, what is the template, what is the view? So basically the question may be asked, explain the model template view architecture of the Django. Otherwise they will ask, explain the Python web application framework for the Django. So these are the some resources. The another one, the important point to be discussed is that, okay, listen, we have discussed the cloud storage models, communication API, then WAF, exactly, Python web application framework, Django, Amazon Web Services, Kinet, IoT messaging platform, and the case studies. Okay, if we are considering the first case study, that is the home intrusion detection system, the primary objective of the home intrusion detection system is to develop an IoT system which can be detect the intrusion with the help of sensor. So system includes the different types of sensors, some network models, some we can require some hardware. Okay, first of all, understand the what are the hardware models we require. The first one hardware model is nothing but camera, PR sensor, door sensor, and the some are embedded board which are that having some efficient resources like processor and the memory. Okay, first the point we'll be discussing is that the sensor that need to be properly physically placed so it can detect the intrusion effectively. And that sensor and the camera is interface with the embedded board, and it is connected to the internet. So user interfacing with the devices like mobile app, we can use the microcontroller like Arduino. Then next one is your BeagleBone board, and the third one is nothing but your Raspberry Pi. And these microcontroller are interfaces with your cameras and the sensor. So alerts related to the intrusion can be sent you with the user app. So next point is required that we have to create the app, so that if the intrusion will be detected, that app will be sending the message or the mail to that owner of that house. So we can use another one is the alarming system. When the intrusion will be detected, alarm will be on. Okay, so these are the basically first one case study. Like that the different case studies we just study 1 by 1.